over here at Shearwater. So today is a lower body and ab day. So the things you are going to need is a chair, and that book bag with about 20 to 30 pounds in it, minus I think 25 pounds, give or take. There's some miscellaneous items in there. But yeah, so that's what you're going to need. And then of course you're going to need your water and some good music. All right. So we're going to do this disclaimer. So in response to COVID-19, PSP is offering virtual fitness to the Canadian Armed Forces members by using social media platforms. The virtual fitness classes tailored to the Canadian Armed Forces members now become accessible to all. Participants who are not Canadian Armed Forces members recognize and acknowledge that their age, health status, and physical fitness levels are completely unknown, and it's entirely up to each individual to assess their ability to participate in this class. Since it is preferable to consult your physician before beginning any exercise program, we invite all participants who are not Canadian Armed Forces members to consult the Get Active questionnaire of the Canadian Society of Physiology and its reference documents. You can find that below in the post. If you experience any pain or difficulty during these exercises presented, please know that it is recommended that you stop immediately and consult your healthcare professional. If a CAF member sustains any type of injury during this video, please remember to fill out a CFID. Awesome.
And we have a comment in here.
Oh, your iPad must have updated. Weird. All right, guys. So yeah, like I said, it is lower body and abs. Not sure where you guys are all watching from, but it's hot as heck out there for us, so I am going to do a Tabata style. My last couple classes have been Tabata styles, but just because, honestly, it's hot here, so if you do want to go a little bit harder than I'm pushing, 100% can do so. If you want to go a little less hard than what I'm doing, maybe it's even hotter where you're at, I don't really know. But yeah, so we're going to be doing it Tabata just so that you can kind of go at your own pace depending on your ability and the climate around you. Perfect. Alright, so again, make sure that you have a book bag with some weight in it and a chair. Alright. Just going to pull my chair a little bit more into focus. I don't know why I threw that all the way over there. Alright guys, so as per usual, or my usual, we're going to do 3 rounds, 3 exercises, let's just get that heart rate up. So we're going to start with 10 squats, followed by 30 mountain climbers, and then 20 shoulder taps. Alright, so again, 3 rounds, we're going to be doing 10, 30, 20, okay? Alright, so squats, going to be a little wider than hip width, we're going to go right into it. So legs a little wider than hip width. We're going to bring your bum parallel to the ground, right back up, give your glute a little squeeze at the top. And that's 5. Couple more here, guys. Almost there. Perfect. And now shoulder taps. Should stay down. So guys, still in high plank position. Tap the shoulders, right hand, left shoulder, left hand, right shoulder. Go for 20. Perfect. And back to our squats. Go for 10. Halfway. And one more here. Perfect. Down into those mountain climbers. Let's go. Almost there. A few more. Awesome. Give your shoulders a tiny break. And then into our shoulder taps. Let's go. Awesome. All right, squats, this is our last round. Almost there, guys. Over half. Perfect. Tiny little break, then inverse shoulder taps. And let's go. That's halfway. Especially if you are doing stationary ones, then you're obviously not going to hug. You're not going to take as much time as I am. And a couple more here, guys. Perfect. Now you need some Frankensteins. So keep that base leg nice and straight. Bring the other leg up, and then touch your toe. Do your hand. A couple little steps. Opposite side. Again, you can do this traveling if you want. If not, that's no big two. We're going to do 10. Only a few more here, guys. Perfect. All right. Now what we're going to do is I want us just do a couple of calf raises. We're going to be doing them later, but just to get kind of in our calf raises. Calf warmed up. Sorry, it's hot. Brain is functional. All right, so I want you to come up onto your tippy toes. Hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back down. Shake it out. Up again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. We're going to do this 5 times. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Second last one, 2, 3, 4, 5, and last one here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Perfect. All right, we're going to do a couple of interims. They're everyone's favorite. So we're going to bend the hips, walking your hands out. You can add a little push-up at the bottom if you want. I don't want to, but you can if you want. We're going to go for 5. So it's 2. And one more here, guys. And walk those feet together. Perfect. All right. So we should be nice and warmed up at this point. So like I said, we are going to be doing a Tabata style class. So what that means is we're going to be doing 8 rounds, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. We are doing alternating movements. So for the most part, I think it's only one pairing. That's 2 legs. We're mostly going to be pairing a leg exercise with a core exercise. Alright, so the first one I have is going to be doing a marching glute bridge. Alright, I think you guys can see me there. So what this looks like is you're going to keep your head and your shoulders on the ground. Bring your hips up. You're going to take the right leg first. Bring it to about that 90 degree angle. Bring it back down. Opposite side. If you find that too challenging, drive those heels in. Bring your hips as far up to the sky as you can. Bring it back down. Or if you do want a little bit of a challenge, take that bag that I was telling you about earlier. Place it right on your abdomen, so right above your hip bones, and then do the marching glute as you're holding your bag. Sorry, I meant to grab my bag before I let it down. All right. We're going to be pairing those with calf raises, so just like what Nice slowing control back down. You can also hold some weight in your hands if you do want to spice things up a little. But yeah. So, like I said, it's a Tabata. Grab a quick drink before we start if you need it. I know I do. Wow. All right. And let's get my Tabata timer going here. All right. So, we're going to be starting in about 5 seconds here. So 3, 2, 1, and I turn my app off. All right, sorry. All right, marching glute, let's go. Raise those hips. 20 seconds here, guys, we can do it. Excellent, keep it up. If this is too much, keep those heels planted on the floor. Turn it into a normal glute variation. Excellent, guys. Keep it up. Keep those hips up. Perfect. Jump right up. We're going into calf raise. Still got about 7 seconds of rest. Again, if you need that chair or something, definitely use it. Let's go. Hold it for a second or two at the top. Again, if you don't like the pace that I'm going at, you can definitely go a little faster, a little slower. But do remember to keep your movements nice and controlled the whole time, all right? 5 seconds left here, calves are burning, keep going. Awesome, 10 seconds off. Three, two, one, let's go, hips up. Excellent, guys, stay with me. Again, if you want this to be a little more challenging, place a weight on your abdomen. Nice controlled here. Perfect. Calf raise is next. Let's go. Hold it for a second or two at the top. Ooh, try to keep your balance. Excellent, guys. Keep it up here. Halfway. Calf should be burning. You're doing great. Keep it up. 3 seconds to go. Perfect. Now you have marching glute. We are halfway. Keep it up, guys. Excellent, almost there. Keep those hips up. Perfect. 3 rounds left. Back into our calf raises. Again, there's no harm in holding on to anything. Ion slits are probably something to hold on to, but here we are. Halfway. Perfect. All right. Marching glute next. 2 rounds left. Hips up. Let's go. Nice and controlled here. If you want to speed it up a bit, you can. But remember, keep your form. Excellent. And last round, calf raises. Excellent, guys. We're almost there. Keep your balance. You got this. 10 seconds left. Three, two, and top half of a normal deadlift, and dead bugs. All right. So Romanian deadlift, what that's gonna look like, is it's super important to keep your shoulders up, back, and down during this exercise. We don't want any rounded shoulders, rounded backs. Definitely not what we want. Spring your shoulders up, back, down. Really squeeze in those shoulder blades. You're gonna hold on to your back. Again, keeping that proper stance. Legs a little wider than hip width. You're gonna keep your back nice and straight, looking about 6 feet in front of you. You're gonna go down to your right, almost touches the ground, and come back up, bring those hips in. Try to keep your legs as straight as you can. We're trying to work on our hamstrings as well as a little bit on our glute. If that is too challenging, you can drop the weight for that. Or you can actually also add weight if you want it to be a little bit more challenging. Okay? So take a second now. You can do a couple more of those to figure out what weight that you want to go at. All right, and then the second one that we're doing, like I said, is our dead bugs. So we're going to bring on our backs, hands up, legs up, about a 90 degree angle. You can take that right hand, left leg, hover about an inch or two off the ground, bring it back to center, off to the side. Just like that. If that's too strenuous on you, we're going to pop over onto our front with bird dog. So we're on our hands and knees here. You're going to take that right hand, left leg. Stretch out as far as you can. Bring it back to center. Opposite side. So when you're stretching your leg out and your arm out, I want you to pretend like you have a string that's going all the way from your toe to your tippy fingers. All right. So, again, still about it. All right, so we're going to restart. All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Again, Romanian deadlifts. Try not to round your back. Looking about 6 feet in front of you the whole time. Keeping your legs as straight as you can. A few more seconds here, guys. Perfect. All right, and dead bugs next. And about 5 seconds here. Let's go. This one's a great core exercise. As well as get your shoulders and your hips moving. It's not too bad as far as ab exercises go. Almost there, guys. Perfect. All right, sweating tons at this point. Woo. And let's start back up. Again, keep those shoulders up, back and down. Squeeze your shoulder blades. Awesome, guys. Keep your legs nice and straight. Pull a few more centered. Excellent, keep it up. Last one here. Perfect. 10 seconds off in our dead bugs. And let's go. Excellent, guys. Keep it up. Let's go. Remember, guys, bring it to about an inch or two off the ground. Perfect. Whew. Shake it up. guys. Keep it up. Halfway down the Sonata. 5 seconds. And let's go. Awesome, guys. Keep it up. We're almost there. Keep it up, guys, keep it up. Guys, stay with me. Perfect. Awesome, guys, shake that out. Bend leg raises. Almost there. Excellent. All right, let's grab some water. Whew. Excellent workout today, guys. All right, we got one final Tabata left. We're almost there. I just have to fix some hair right quick, sorry about that. But, okay, so the last Tabata that we have is going to be alternating step-ups and Superman. So with the step-ups, if you want, you can definitely grab onto that weight that we got earlier to make it a little bit more challenging. But we're going to be the chair for this part. So here, pull a little bit closer. Awesome. All right, guys, so for step-ups, more or less is exactly what it sounds like. You can step up to that chair. First, I'm going to go right leg. Follow through with the left. Left down first. Right down. So right up. Left down. Right down. If you want, like I said, you can grab onto your weight. Or you can also, as you go up, instead of touching your left foot to the chair, fire it up until it's parallel with the ground. I'll explain what that means. So we're going to go left leg. Right leg is firing up. This one does require a bit more balance, obviously. Again, that's just to challenge you a little bit if you want that extra challenge. If you find those a bit too much, especially if you have any type of knee issues, pop your hands on your hips, in the back of your head, go to some lunges. Working the same muscles, just targeting them a little bit differently. Just like that. All right. And like I said, we're pairing it with Superman. Superman, surprise, surprise, we're back down on the ground. What we're gonna do is you're gonna lift your arms and your legs up. Ooh, my knees are sliding. So you can either hold the pose for the whole 20 seconds, just like this, adding in a little bit of flutter if you want. Or we can also go right hand, left leg. Or you can go both hands, both legs. So a couple of different alterations there for you. Like I said, if you want to walk the whole time, A1. But if you do want to try a modification, you can try those out. Alright guys, this is going to be your last Tabata. So I really want you to go all out on this one. Alright? on, let's go. I'm leading with my right leg for the first 20 seconds, and I'm going to switch to the left leg for the second 20. You guys can alternate for each 20 if you want. It's kind of like a build your own adventure if you want. Perfect. All right, Supermans are next. So again, try it out. Maybe you want to do a modification for each separate one. All right, 20 seconds, let's go. Try to keep your knees and your elbows up off the ground, keeping everything as straight as you can. So guys, keep it up. 10 seconds left. Perfect. Grab water at any point if you need to. All right, down there, Superman again. Let's go. You can add in a flutter here if you want to. Keep going. Perfect. All right, I'm back to leading with my right leg for the step ups. And you guys can go faster than I'm going, slower than I'm going. Taking some breaks if you need to. Almost there, guys. Perfect. Superman next. Keep pushing, guys, halfway. Excellent. Last one off the step ups. Awesome, guys, halfway. Few seconds left. Done. All right. And last round of Supermans and we're done, so. Perfect. Awesome, guys. All right, grab some water. I know I need it. Let our heart rate come down a little, then we'll go into our stretch. Thanks so much for joining me today, guys. It is extremely hot out there. The humidity is out of the world. So make sure you are drinking tons of water, especially if you are exerting yourself. Just make sure you pound back the water. Alright guys, we're going to start with a standing quad. I'm going to move this chair just because my balance is pretty off today. I don't want to fall. Alright, so I want you to grab, we're going to start with the right leg. So grab your foot, bring your heel up to your bum. Try to keep your knees as close together as
come to a chair.
Oh, I don't need a chair. Icing guys are just gonna hold this for a little bit longer. Ooh, sweating tons. Perfect, shake that out. And opposite side. Again, try to keep your knees as close together as possible. Bring your heel up to your bum. Perfect. Alright, next. You're gonna spread your legs wider than hip width. I want you to reach up. And we're gonna bend at the hips. Touch the ground. Once you're down here, you might want to spread your legs a little bit more. Try to walk your hands towards yourself. Stretching out our hamstrings. Perfect. Bring it right down to the ground from there. Alright. We're going to sit down. You're going to take your right leg first. Bring the heel of your left foot into the inside of that right thigh. You're going to reach for that toe. If you can't touch your toe, grab onto your shin at some point. A couple more seconds here. Perfect. Alright. Opposite side again. Left leg straight out. Right foot to the inside of the thigh. Reaching for the toe. If you can't reach the toe, just hold on to a part of your leg. Excellent. Alright, so this one is a little bit trickier. What you're going to do, so you keep your left foot straight out in front of you. You're going to take your right leg, placing your heel as close to your bum as you can while still sitting up, if you guys can see what I mean. So you're going to try to tuck that in and lean back just slightly. So you should feel it all up your quad. It's starting from the outside of your right hip, going to the inside of your right knee, okay? So again, you have your heel close to your hip on your right hand side, we're just leaning back. Awesome. Alright, now right leg straight out, left leg bent, leaning back. If you can lean back farther than I am, excellent. I can't. My muscles are pretty tight right now. Perfect. Alright, now we're going to go on our right hands and knees into some cat-cows. So as you're breathing, you're going to round the back. As you breathe out, you're going to look up to the sky and arch your back. We're going to go for five. That's two. Three. Four. And one more. Five. All right, so now you're going to drop down onto your belly. You're going to point your toes behind you, hands underneath your shoulders, lifting up slightly. This is too much strain on your lower back, then drop down on the forearms. Then up onto the hands and knees, bring your bum down to your heels. Arms straight out in front of you. Excellent. All right, guys, that is what I have for you today. Thanks so much for joining in, and have a safe and happy weekend. All right, see you later, guys.